name is Holly. I'm a junior here at HPU. My major is elementary education and I'm minoring in psychology. And I have been the BSU president for this last year and this year. And the way I got started in it, it's kind of a weird story. I didn't know that there was a BSU on campus. And it turns out there had been one in the past, but it kind of died out a little bit. And then when I was a freshman, a group tried to revive it, but then that group ended up leaving HPU. The person who was the faculty advisor at the time asked me if I'd like to step in, and I agreed to do it because I believe that Black student unions are so important in order to foster community. And there are Black people at HPU. It's just sometimes hard to see them, and you know, they kind of seem like a minority population, but in reality we're not. So I'm super excited to be part of a club that's so important, and to me, as long as we're part of the community and supporting the community here at HPU, that we're doing our job. And I'm honored to have been the president for these past 2 years.
All right, we're gonna try this again. Hi, my name is Olivia. I am a junior in the Multimedia Cinematic Production department at HPU, class of 2022. And I'm from Washington, D.C., Chocolate City itself, or what it used to be before it was heavily gentrified. And I think seeing all those changes happening before my eyes was really hard to watch coming from high school, so I wanted to go as far away as possible, and I ended up here. And HPU has definitely given me a wide range of experiences, from working on set for movies and TV shows alike. I've been a production assistant for the past 3 years, and I'm often the only Black woman on set, usually the youngest person on set, and it really warms my heart to be able to represent the Black community and the HPU community as well in that space. You know, there is a very low percentage of the population that's Black at HPU, and I think that is all the more reason to support the Black Student Union. And I think ways in which HPU can definitely continue to create spaces for us is to fund these spaces, to hire more Black professors and faculty and staff at HPU, to truly advise us, creating cultural centers and courses that really do educate the non-Black students at HPU. I think that they can also expand the study abroad programs to reach more countries in Africa. Right now, there's heavily colonized countries that are, you know, really being focused in at study abroad, and I think like South Africa. And I think that can also be expanded to a plethora of experiences that, you know, can better and accurately describe and embody what Africa is. And I am really honored to say that I'm a part of the Black community at HPU, and I want to wish you guys all a happy Black History Month.
Hi, I'm Chloe Robinson. I'm 19 years old. I'm a freshman. My major is psych. And why did I choose HPU? I chose HPU because they had given me like a lot of money for scholarships, and they said that during like this whole COVID pandemic thing that they were still gonna have in-person classes, but that didn't happen. So my first impression of HPU was that like it was like a mostly like white campus. Like I thought that it was supposed to be like the most diverse campus, and that you know, I thought that there were going to be more locals, since it is Hawaii, like there would be more locals going to HPU, but there wasn't. It was just mostly like white students. And do I feel comfortable around my peers? I would have to say no, because like people here, like, they act like they've never seen black people before, and I thought that there would be, like, more diversity and, like, more, like, they'd be more, like, inclusive towards, like, LGBT and people of color, but that's not, like, the energy I got from the people on this campus. So, what resources or events would you offer to offset the outside factors that may hinder your growth as a student? I know that there's a Black Student Union on campus, but I never really see it advertised, especially now during Black History Month. Like, I don't see, like, any posts, any, like, emails, nothing from HBU, like, saying that, you know, Black Student Union is, like, holding an event, or this and the third. Like, I never really see that. And I didn't know Black Student Union was providing resources and helping, like, active on campus, because there was never, like, anything, like, it was never made aware towards all the students. And I would say, like, incoming Black students that want to go to HBU, I would say don't come here, just because, like, you want to feel, like, safe and comfortable in, like, the place that you would consider, like, your home for the next 4 years, and, like, the education. I would want them to feel, like, more comfortable and more, like, given more opportunities and, like, be able to call this, like, a safe space for them. But I would say that that's not a safe, like, this campus isn't necessarily a safe space for Black students who want to go to this school.
Hi, my name is Mikaela Hawan. I am 19 years old. I am currently a freshman at HPU. My major is criminal justice, and I'm hopefully trying to be a part of SWAT as my future career. So why did I choose HPU? I chose HPU for the criminal justice program, and it was, like, one of the best that I was looking at for, based off of all the schools that I was applying to, it was one of the best programs. And also because looking at, like, the website and talking to some of the administration, a lot of them said that HPU was very diverse and that it, like, you would literally see a whole bunch of people of every race, ethnicity, and, like, culture around. And I was really intrigued by that, and I really liked that. So I was like, okay, cool, like, I am interested in HPU. And the one thing that I wish that I did was tour before I chose to come. Just to see the campus, see, like, you know, every student walking around, seeing how diverse this school really is. But yeah, I just wish that I could have taken a tour before initially saying, okay, like, this is a school for me. But I am happy to still be here. So my first impressions upon arrival, I loved the campus immediately. I loved how it's not your everyday, like, campus. I love how at ATM the dorms are mainly outside. I really like that, and I like the outside and, like, kind of like being, like, in paradise type of feel. It's really, really nice. But then again, HPU wasn't as diverse as people were saying that it was, which kind of, in some circumstances, it did make me feel a little bit uncomfortable, just because some of the things that have happened, especially the fall semester, it was really bad, and sometimes I would have people coming up to me saying some really negative things, or just, like, kind of looking at me weirdly just because of my skin color and, like, my background. And, you know, a lot of people can't necessarily figure out exactly what I am, but I am part Black. And a lot of people do discriminate because of that, and I've been called some rude names, most definitely, especially when all the riots were happening with the presidential debate and the everything that was happening, and we had I wouldn't say like a riot or anything first semester, but a lot of stuff definitely did happen, and a lot of stuff definitely did go down, and it was just very overwhelming, I would say. But yeah, it was definitely an interesting first semester. But mainly the people that I have met here are very welcoming, open arms. Like, it's really wonderful, it's beautiful, and most of the people that I have met do not discriminate and are very, very open, and, you know, they don't necessarily make me feel out of place or uncomfortable, which I really like. Let's see, as a Black person, do you feel comfortable among your peers at school? For the most part, most definitely, yes. That kind of ties in with what I said earlier, due to, like, I have randomly, somebody came up to me and literally just called me the N-word. I was like, oh, okay, that's how we're doing things, that's great. It was, you know, that was definitely uncomfortable, and that definitely made me feel uncomfortable at the school, just because I always want to feel comfortable at, like, where I am and where I live and at school. You know, nobody wants to feel uncomfortable or feel unwanted. And in that moment, I definitely did. But it has gotten better. And it feels a lot safer, I would say, just because I have surrounded myself with people who are very, very good people and genuine people. And that they wouldn't, you know, go around and call me that. They aren't racist. They don't say negative things. They don't say any racist slurs, which is really nice. Because part of me has been around that, just because I am a very mixed child, and you know, a lot of people have called me some very racist things. But definitely at HBU, it doesn't happen a lot to me, but it has happened. And then, did you know the Black Student Union was active on campus and provided resources to help develop students of color? So I actually found out about BSU from Joshua Hardy. I became really close friends with him. I met him at Pier 9 because he worked there. And honestly, he is one of my, like, the greatest friends I've made here at HBU. He really helped me get through a lot. And I know that he is the VP of BSU. So that's how I initially found out about it. And I was actually really excited to make this video because I want people's voices to be heard. I want my voice to be heard. And I want people to basically be aware that, hey, this is what's going on at our school, like, people need to wake up, you know. So I'm really happy that this video is being made. But I actually did not know that they provided resources to help develop students of color. I mean, you know, with this video, it's definitely going to help a lot. With other resources, it's definitely going to help a lot, and I'm really, really excited to see what, like, how everything is going to come to be, and what is going to happen with BSU, and how they're really, I really believe that they're going to make an impact, especially with the leaders that they have on board now. I'm really excited for that, and to see, like, a change at the school, because I definitely, personally feel as though there should be a change. You know, if there's marketing that's saying that we are a diverse campus, and, you know, some people step on a campus and see that it's not as diverse as they say, it kind of really drives them in a different direction, and I would never want that, because HBU is a good school, and, you know, there's a lot of people here to help you, and there's a lot of people here that are going to support you, and everybody should feel comfortable and feel that support, no matter what, no matter their color, race, or ethnicity. But yeah, so I am definitely really excited to see what BSU comes up with in the future. What would you say to incoming Black students looking to make HBU their home college? I would definitely say that you aren't alone. You should never feel alone. I would never ever want an African American student to come on a campus and, you know, see that majority of the campus may be white. I don't want them to feel uncomfortable. I don't want them to as though they might get separated from certain things or events or opportunities. Like, nobody should ever feel that way. I would definitely come visit the co- college. Absolutely. That's the one mistake that I made. Definitely come visit the college, see if you like it. If you can, meet some people, you know, kind of do your research online and through social media and get different people's inputs on the school and how it is as a person of color. But that's why I definitely think that this video will help with that, just because you are seeing people of color that are going to HPU and just kind of explaining their experience while being a person of color at HPU. But definitely do your research first. Definitely come visit the school, see how you like it, see if it's a good fit for you. And, you know, I mean, I have fortunately haven't had the worst experience being a person of color, but, you know, I don't know what everybody else is going through out there, and I definitely want to be there for everybody. But for sure, 110% BSU and their leaders and everybody who is a part of BSU will be there for you no matter what to help you and welcome you with open arms.
My name is Sinead Barrette. I'm 18 years old. I'm a freshman at HPU and I'm a political science major. I chose HPU because, one, it's in Hawaii. Who wouldn't want to come to Hawaii? Two, because I heard the diversity rate was high and I wanted to go to a diverse school because a lot of the schools in the mainland are PWIs, and as an African American woman, I feel like those schools wouldn't prioritize my education. And three, because it was in person, a lot of schools because of the pandemic are still on Zoom. My first impression of HPU was, where's the diversity at? Because walking around campus, I noticed there wasn't a lot of PLCs on campus, and luckily I got lucky with two PLC roommates, but I feel like that's like the most PLCs in one room compared to like the rest of the campus. Like in the dining hall, all you see is like Caucasian people, and it's kind of weird because they constantly stare at you like you're an animal and they never seen PLCs ever in their life, and you kind of feel judged and unwanted just by the stares and almost sort of like an animal in a zoo. I also noticed upon arrival that the way they're enforcing the social distancing rules, like a lot of the students, especially the Caucasian students, you tend to see a pattern. They don't wear their masks around campus. They walk around and rules aren't being enforced. But like for me, like my other PLC friends, luckily I was able to find some, they would get reported all the time by the CAs and stuff like that for not wearing the mask when they were eating or drinking and stuff like that. But these other students who constantly walk around without masks, nothing was being told to them. And it's just not me who only feels this way. A lot of the other PLC students felt this way, and that's why a lot of them left HPU. For me, my expectation as a Black student was to succeed in all my studies, make friends that are also like me and have similar backgrounds to me. And a lot of those expectations, for me, my grades wise, it was good and everything. Like, I did not feel like I belonged here as to why I wanted to transfer out of HPU like most of my other peers did. As an African American student at this school, I do not feel comfortable around my peers as to why I want to leave this school. I feel like they're always so prejudiced and like almost sort of like racially profiling you here. Like, Hawaii is a beautiful island. I would love to continue living here, but this school just made me not want to be here at all. There's a lot of racist students on campus. And like whenever stuff is like reported about them not wearing masks, stuff they say, this, that, and third, nothing happens. But then when it comes to a PLC, they're quick to like suspend students, kick them out, ban them from housing, this, that, and the third. There's literally Caucasian students saying the N-word in 2021 and last semester of 2020. And again, nothing's done. As an African American student, of course I felt impacted by the outside events that were happening, like the election, the BLM protests, all that stuff. And of course it made stuff like stressful, especially during the election time. Luckily HPU does have a school therapist who's really helpful and like I was able to talk to whenever I was feeling anxious or whatnot, so that kind of helped with my mental health. But my mental health is still not in the best place of mind, especially being in this school. Also, I like to add how in the beginning of Black History Month, HPU did not make no announcement or say anything about Black History Month, but they had a whole this or that quiz on their Instagram instead of posting awareness about Black History Month and like past events that happened. A student actually had to bring it to their attention and DM the Instagram account, and they left her on scene. And it shows you, are we really a priority to them or we're just money? and a diversity quota. Also, I did not know the Black Student Union was active on campus, and I honestly didn't know it was a thing because HBU does not take the time to advertise it to their Black students. And they could say it's on the club websites, whatever, whatever, but like, they post about all these other clubs and events and stuff like that, but I feel like Black Student Union is something they should and can talk about, but they choose not to. A Black student population, you would think they would advertise this for other Black students, like to get to know each other and stuff like that, but I feel like we have a community here on campus since we're already surrounded by other people that are not like us. I honestly improve the Black experience on campus by making the campus more inclusive for all types of students, so we don't have to feel judged and unwanted. Like, I feel like they should create a more safe space and prioritize the Black Student Union and other unions for other POCs. I would say to future students wanting to make HBU their home, good luck, and you might need to start some researching schools to transfer to, because this school does not care about African American students nor POCs. And they'll most likely only care if you're a student athlete or you hold some sort of significance to the school. My experience is different, and this just so happened to be me and many of my other peers similar.
Hi, my name is Candace Montgomery. I'm 18 years old and currently enrolled as a freshman at Hawaii Pacific University. I am majoring in a BS in biology with a concentration in human health sciences. The reason that I chose Hawaii Pacific University was because it was close to home for me, along with their great sports program. As a Black student, attending a PWI, I didn't think that there would be many Black students. I thought that there would at least be a Black club or active community that reached out to the students. I was expecting the school to even be involved in some of the Black culture or broadcasting the current events. I was definitely disappointed when I didn't see any of these things happening, along with the fact that they didn't post anything for Black History Month. I was not even aware that we had a Black Student Union active club on our campus. I would definitely improve the Black experience by having the union reach out to the admitted students or even the incoming freshmen. I think that this can not only open up opportunities for the club, but also for the students. A tip for incoming Black students would be to find friends or people of color outside of your school. This island is not that big, so I think that it'd be really easy for you to find Black students from all over the island.
Hi, my name is Ivy. I am a first-year junior here at HPU, and my major is marine biology with a minor in sustainability. And after pursuing my master's, I plan to hopefully work for National Geographic. Now, why did I choose HPU? Well, a lot of my upperclassmen when I was in high school, they always told me, get a college tour, get a tour of the campus, get a feel for what it's like to be there. And if it's the right place for you, then you'll know. It'll just feel like home. And when I first got to HPU and I was a part of their preview day, I just immediately fell in love. I am a lover of Polynesian culture. I myself do Polynesian dancing, so it was just really nice being in Hawaii and really seeing how many Native kids were on campus. And then I am a lover of sharks as well. And so when I found out that the mascot was a shark, and there was an unofficial mascot that an upperclassman Tatiana told me about named George the Tiger Shark, immediately I thought, this is where I need to be. This is a sign that I was meant to be here. But my expectations for the school, they were pretty high. I expected there to be a lot more diversity. I expected to, you know, feel really in tune with the culture, even if I wasn't taking the Hawaiian culture class or anything. But I feel like I'm not really experiencing much of the Hawaiian culture. Yes, COVID has changed a lot of things last semester and this semester, but I still didn't feel like I was connecting on a more local level, really understanding their language, their background, the history, different things like that. Even with the food, I was expecting more diversity in the food. But in other ways, I do believe that just one being in Hawaii, that's like a dream come true for me and many people. And then the people that I've worked with and talked to, they've been amazing. My professors, small classes, I feel like if you really take the time, you can really connect with your professors, and that's also part of the reason why I chose HPU. I want to be able to talk to my professors, talk to any of my professors, and get feedback, get advice, get help. And I really do think that that aspect, my expectations have been met. And I think that as I continue on to my senior year, things will only get better. But to any incoming African American or Black students, I would say that this school, as lovely as it is, I do not believe it is meant for those of the BIPOC community outside of Native Hawaiians. One, very, very costly scholarships and maybe even federal work study would be your best friend. And I believe that there are some people that treat us slightly differently. I have noticed within classes there are certain professors, they just seem to, not necessarily that they mean to, but they seem to pick based off of who you are and how you look from day one. And it can be a bit frustrating. Even when my mom and I, when we spoke with a professor who I will remain unnamed, but when I told him that my dream was to be a shark biologist and work for National Geographic, he told me that, oh, that's a dream job. We like to be more realistic here. To my African American people, one thing that I truly am passionate about is bringing up the next generation, and even kids within my own generation. Never let someone tell you that, oh, that's just a dream job, think more realistic. No, dreams are what motivate you. Dreams are what push you to show people that we are better than what you might see on the media, as crazy as it may seem. That we can do these things, and that we're just as motivated as a Caucasian, as a Native, as any other person of any color, and that we can do this. So if you decide to make HPU your school, you may feel left out. You may feel like you're the only person in your class that understands your point of view, because there will be some classes, especially in the STEM field, I have noticed there are not a lot of African American students. There are not a lot of people of color aside from maybe a Native. And I believe that it should just push you forward even more, and that you should know deep down in your mind, in your heart, that you can do just as well, if not better than some, because you are here for a reason. You came here. You worked just as hard as anybody else to get to where you are now. And sometimes it's not shown in grades. Not everything is shown in grades. So as long as you really push yourself and you show people that this is not a game, that you're meant to be here, I think you will do great. And just never forget that if you come to HPU. Bye.
Hello, I'm Lori Leach, and I'm a professor of English at HPU, and I'm also, for the past year and a half, the associate dean for the College of Liberal Arts. And I chose my profession based on my experiences in my English literature classes at the University of Virginia. So in my first semester, I was in a class with Professor Vanessa Saunders. She's an African-American woman whose specialty was Victorian literature. But I was taking studies in fiction with her, and one of the texts that she included was Toni Morrison's The Bluest Eye. And I was really just blown away by that book. And it really made me think about race, probably for one of the first times in my life. And I just found it to be very meaningful. And I went and talked to her to Dr. Saunders about the book and asked her to recommend other books I could read because I really hadn't read much African-American literature at that point. And through talking to her, she eventually became my advisor, and she was the one who suggested that, oh, you know, you're good at analyzing literature and talking about it. You should go to grad school for this. You should be a college professor. And I eventually decided that that's what I wanted to do. So in grad school, I had more opportunities to work with Black faculty, fellow Black grad students, and I read more African-American literature. Even though that wasn't my particular specialty, I focused more on autobiographies, but there are a lot of very powerful African-American autobiographies, and so that kind of reinforced my interest there. And when I came to HPU, I was basically hired as a generalist. At first, I just only taught Writing 1100, 1200, and Introduction to Literature, where I had the pleasure of teaching Langston Hughes, who I eventually ended up writing a book about. And I just gradually developed more courses in things like literature of slavery, ethnic lit, and I also bring issues about race and racial justice into some of my other courses sometimes, such as Writing 1200 or Research in Writing and Humanities. And I think it's important to have those kinds of discussions for all students. And my experience of taking the class with Dr. Saunders is an example of the importance of having a diverse faculty. And I think that that is something that HPU does need to work on. I think the current situation is sort of the result of us not being able to hire many faculty in recent years. And in fact, our faculty has been shrinking as people move away, and has resulted in the fact that right now we don't have a very diverse faculty, but something we know that we want to see happen in the future, as well as continuing to develop our curriculum to include these kinds of topics.
My name is Jason Howley, and I'm the Title IX coordinator here at HPU. I'm in my second semester on campus, which for me has been dope. And so first question I was asked is, how did you decide on your profession? You know, and I would say I kind of stumbled into it, right? I wasn't necessarily trying to be in higher education and do this work. But, you know, when I retired from professional basketball, you know, I had a discussion with my former dean of students at Pomona College, Ann Quinley. And we sat down and we talked about all that she had done for me. And I wanted to be that person for other folks, you know, especially for folks that look like me. You know, Ann Quinley is an amazing white woman, and not everybody's going to be able to connect with her or find that connection or see that connection, see themselves in her. So I knew that she was the person that I went to, and I don't know if other folks who look like me would go to her, right? So I thought there'd need to be more of me in higher education, you know, folks who came from low-income backgrounds, who are Black or mixed race, biracial, or, you know, not affluent, right? There's just not a lot of me in these, you know, not a lot of folks like me in these spaces. So, you know, I kind of stumbled through it, you know. I found some great mentors, some folks like Kenny Donaldson at UCLA, Janae Davis at UCLA, Tim Chang, who was at Occidental at the time, is now at Emerson College, right? And Michelle Javi Mears at Soka University, Jamie Washington at the Social Justice Training Institute, Vernon Walls, Social Justice Training Institute, Becky Martinez, Social Justice Training Institute. Like, I just found mentors, and they kind of guided me and molded me into this person. And you know, events that occurred throughout, you know, throughout my lifetime did too, right? You know, Trayvon Martin was really impactful when I was in grad school, and you know, in New York City at Columbia, and I just, it was one of the things where I was like, yo, I want to do this work professionally. I want to help folks who don't necessarily get their voices heard, and be that that place and create that space where folks feel like they can come in and know that I'm going to hear them, and they're going to have an advocate, a champion in me, and I'm going to use my any ounce of privilege that I got, and I'm going to assist in however I can. So question two, do you believe HPU provides everything Black students need to succeed? You know, I don't know, right? In this pandemic, it has been the most difficult for me to connect with students, right? Like, I just don't see people. Like, I see people as walk by, but like, because of COVID, you know, the amount of time and interaction I have is so minimal, right? And you know, I'm in a role where, you know, only certain people come to me. You know, I don't necessarily always get folks of color in these spaces sharing their stories and their narratives and, you know, asking for advice. I don't know. I have to spend more time connecting with Black folks on campus to see if that's the case. I don't want to just be like, yeah, you know, HPU definitely is doing everything possible, you know, because I don't know if that's true. You know, I like to be real 100. I would like to believe that they're willing to step into the fold and do what's necessary for Black students to be successful here. But I'd also have to, you know, talk to folks more to gauge their experience, to get a true sense of that, right? So how do I help? No, question three is, how do I help students struggling with social, cultural, political, and economic depression from an educational standpoint? And, you know, I would say I do what I always do, and I create space, right? I do programming. I advocate for policies. I create initiatives, right? Like, I do things that make sure that when folks are struggling, especially folks who look like me, that they have a place. They have they know that there's some place that they can go to hear their voice, to get some advice, and be that mentor that I, you know, that mentor that I had for me, right? Like, the mentor that I had for me, I'm trying to be that. I'm trying to be that for students who are going through it today. So I'm here, and I listen, non-judgmental. I do programming, you know, both within the student population and within the faculty, that helps to address issues like microaggression. You know, Real Honest talks about masculinity and real discussions about race and politics and all the things that encompasses the lived experience of Black folks. So those are the things I do. I host conversations, I do programs, initiatives, I'm there for folks, I listen, and you know, I'm always there for folks. So question four, as a professional at HPU, have you noticed any gaps in treatment of students of color among colleagues? You know, I haven't, but then again, you know, this pandemic is different. You know, it's tough to say. You know, I always have to question it when things happen. You know, is it, you know, I question it in myself first and foremost, but I also have to question in others. Is that reaction, whatever the reaction is that strikes me as odd, you know, what's that based on? And if I get an opportunity, I'll ask that person, but, you know, I'll ask the folks who do that. But normally, you know, it's always tough to see, because these sorts of things are at the micro level, right? they're rarely at the macro level. They're rarely the old school racism. You know, they're the subtle cuts, the deep cuts, the difference in tone, the presence, the feeling and the warmth of acceptance that is lacking sometimes, right? And you know, last night there was a mention about in criminal justice. There, you know, one of the mentions in the comment section on our perspectives on racial justice in America, somebody said that, you know, in some of the criminal justice programs, they hear those comments that are victim blaming. They blame Black folks, you know, unarmed Black men for being shot by police, right? And for me, that is one of the issues that I'm trying to address, right? It's never the victim's fault. Like, you can say that victim blaming stuff, as I'm not having it. So yeah, you know, I haven't noticed it, but I'm always trying to be present and aware of those issues and try to be prepared to confront them when there are those gaps appear. Question number 5. Do you or would you recommend HPU to students of color looking to make Hawaii their home? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I'm here, right? Like, I wouldn't be here if I didn't think that there was the potential for it to feel comfortable, or the actual presence of feeling comfort for me, right? I feel comfortable in this space. That doesn't mean all folks of color, all Black students will feel comfortable, but you know that if I'm here, there's that chance, right? There's that opportunity that you know that somebody's gonna be in there riding for you, it's gonna be advocating for you, gonna be trying to create pathways and opportunities and spaces and places for you to feel comfortable here, right? And I'm not necessarily, I mean, I talk, right? But I'm more about action, so I try to be about it, not just talk about it, right? Like, people can talk a big game all they want, but like, can you put your skin in the game, you know? Will you push the envelope to ensure that these spaces are what they say they are? And I will always do that. And I think there's nothing more important than, you know, being who you say you are. You know, if you got a mission statement, you got values, like, do you live up to those values constantly? And I feel like with who's here and what they're trying to accomplish and the initiatives that they're working on and their willingness to put me into spaces and places that help move those initiatives forward or create those initiatives, I think this is a place where you can be, you can find home, you can find community, you can feel comfortable. So yeah, I recommend it. Come on through. Question 6. Do you think HPU can improve on its inclusion of African American students? And if so, how? I think there should always be a push to find and create space, both the sense of space, virtual space, and physical space for Black folks, right? Like, there needs to be spaces where people can congregate and get together and feel like they are in community. You know, community is made and maintained in various forms and ways, and a big piece of the culture is creating those spaces, is making that possible. You know, there are things that I really will look to hope to introduce here at HPU that have always been a big piece of what I do. You know, my baby, which is Hope in Action, right? It's a program initiative that I've instituted at other institutions, and I want to institute that here post-COVID, right? Or when we can get back in community, in proximity to one another. I want to implement those programs, because those pieces that create that program, art, music, activism, discussions, dialogue, food, right? Those things are so endemic and so true to the culture that, you know, trying to do them outside of proximity is you know, not necessarily what I'm looking to do. I don't think it lands the same, and it don't hit the same. So, you know, creating space to make sure, you know, it hit different is what I do. And so, you know, I think there are ways that folks we can continue to, you know, make this space inclusive, right? We do more training for faculty, for staff. You know, had a bunch of folks attend a microaggression training that I did, which is dope. And we can do more, right? We can do more in terms of how we are creating the space necessary to be truly inclusive and not just talk about inclusivity. You know, in addition, you know, there's initiatives coming down from the president's office and dean of students' office around some diversity, equity, and inclusion that, you know, will touch the lives of Black students and students of color and underrepresented students, and be impactful, right? And things that I'm working on and things we hope to implement coming in the next fall semester and moving forward. So, yeah, there's some things we can get done and improve and make this space really inclusive. But we also have some great people up top that are willing to do that, and willing to make that space and really push those initiatives, push forward and progress in ways that are thinking of students of color, thinking of Black folks, thinking of underrepresented folks. So there's some dope things in the works, and I hope you all come out and continue, you know, to be part and tell us how you feeling, what this feels like for you, and what we can do to make this home feel like home and a sense of community for you. So thank you. Appreciate you.
Hi, my name is Joshua Hardy. I'm the vice president of BSU. I'm a junior here at Hawaii Pacific University, and I'm majoring in business management. The reason I came to Hawaii is because it's not only a paradise. I was seeking out diversity, and I wanted to feel comfortable in my environment and not be judged based on the color of my skin or the way that I talk or where I'm from. As for my expectations when I first arrived here at HPU, I expected to see a good mix of both Asian, Black, European, Pacific Islander type of diversity. That was my mistake, because I didn't look at the statistics for the school. This is a predominantly white school. I wasn't well received by my peers when I first got here either, which led to some adversity. I had a lot of personal adversity coming in. I'm not from the wealthiest family. We're middle class. So I had to work essentially four jobs in order to stay in the dorms and stay here at HPU for the year and a half that I was here. As for outside adversity, like I said, I wasn't well received by the students or my peers. I often get looked at oddly. My music isn't well received at all. They whisper things behind your back. You know, I know it's childish, but it happens. Starting in 2020, in February, I actually lost my grandmother, which led me to be a little depressed. Not a little, just depressed overall. I was already kind of depressed because I wasn't making the amount of friends that I thought I was, or the connections that I thought I was when I first got here. just not having the time to participate in certain clubs because of the way that I was working and my school load, it overwhelmed me at times. And there were times where I had to go to therapy to get the help that I needed to stay on track and work the way that I did. As for the summer of 2020, when COVID hit, I lost a lot of my jobs. There wasn't anything put out by HPU to comfort the students after the incident with George Floyd, or even for Black History Month now. So diversity and awareness and support for its minorities is something that HPU isn't very big on right now. Late in December, I decided to join BSU, and that's because I wanted to be a catalyst for change at this school. I wanted to be more active and be involved and be able to see familiar faces rather than be alone, because when you're isolated on the island alone as a person of color, it really gets to you. When you aren't making those connections, you enter into a space that you don't want to be in. And so for me, joining BSU was not only personal, but I never wanted anybody else to feel that way, to feel the way that I was feeling inside all the time, either. As for incoming students coming to HPU, I would tell you and advise you to make informed decisions, to be aware of your surroundings, and to always be hopeful. Through all that I've been through and through the things that I've seen here at HPU, I'm still here. You know, this can be your home. So don't ever let anybody take that away from you. Always make your informed decisions, and don't base your decisions off of what anybody else has to say. Experience things for yourself. You can go to school at VCU, you can go to school in Oklahoma, you can go to school in South Africa. It doesn't matter where you are, you're always going to face some type of adversity. And it's important for you to work through that. It's important for you to grow as a person. As humans, we are social beings, so it's important that we're celebrated every single day, not just this month. I'm Black 365 days of the year, not just in February. And it's important for us to celebrate and take pride every day in our culture and being who we are as individuals and celebrate together. I thank everyone for participating in this video, and hopefully we'll be able to do more events like these in the future and be able to work together to create a brighter future for the world. Thank you. Happy Black History Month. Mahalo.